Namaste. Let us work out a problem where you have to prepare the balance sheet as well as profit and loss account. Following is the trial balance of Vikas Bank Limited as on 31/3/2015. So they have given the trial balance. There are different items. The first and foremost thing is you have to identify which schedule it belongs to. Okay, for this purpose, you have to study all the schedules thoroughly. Schedule 1, what are the items are included? So like that, you have to study properly. So here, we can see one by one. Paid up capital, so share capital, schedule 1. Reserve fund, 2, reserves and surplus. Loans, cash credit and overdrafts. Schedule 9, because it is advances. It is an asset. We are giving the advances to the public, right? Then, premises, 10, fixed assets. Indian government securities. This is investment. So, schedule 8. Current deposits. So, it comes under deposits, 3. Fixed deposits. Again, deposits, 3. Savings bank deposits, 3. Recurring deposits, 3. Salary, where does it appear? Operating expenses, 16. General expenses, 16. Rent and rates and taxes, 16. Director's fees, see all these are operating expenses, schedule 16. Then profit and loss account, opening balance they have given. So last year's profit, where does it appear? In the profit and loss account. Okay, we have to write this last year's, so no schedule but profit and loss account it comes. Interest and discount, this is interest earned, schedule 13. Bills purchased and discounted, so this is also advances, so giving it to the public. And you can see carefully, see all these things are in the debit side. Okay, so this is like how we treat bills receivable. Same thing. So, bills receivable is an asset, right? So, bills purchased and discounted also an asset. So, it comes under schedule 9 as advances. Advances given. Then, stock of stationery. So, stationery, other assets. It is not fixed assets, right? Other assets, 11. Commission and exchange. So, commission and exchange, other income. So, 14. So, interim dividend. Where does it appear? Interim dividend. So you know, there is no particular schedule about this, but this is appropriation. After getting the profit, net profit, we can pay the dividends, right? So interim dividend in the appropriation in the profit and loss account. Then investments. Investments comes under investment, schedule 8. Then cash in hand and with RBA. So same thing, cash and balances with RBA, schedule 6. Then money at call and short notice. So on the asset side, we have to write under schedule 7, balances with banks and money at call and short notice. Under that we have to write balance with other banks, same thing. Balances with banks and money at call and short notice. So all these things, there is a separate heading, right? Schedule number 7, you can make out. So all these things we identified. But by looking at the problem, if they have given trial balance, you should be very careful to see whether they have given debit balance or credit balance. Sometimes commission is given. The commission is given. Here it is credit, right? So credit means what? It is income. If they have given commission on the debit side, it is an expense. It goes to the other expense, operating expenses. So should be very careful. So they have given the adjustments. You know, in the adjustment, whatever appears, it appears twice. In the trial balance, whatever appears, it appears only once. Okay, here, provision for bad and doubtful debts required is amounting to rupees 1500. So 1500, where we have to appear? Provision for bad debts. Under schedule 16, what is that? See, under schedule 16, what do we write? Operating expenses, right? After that, there is a place, provision and contingencies we write. So after that, we have to write like this, provision, 1500. Another entry, from advances, schedule number 9. So from advances, we have to deduct this. What is the reason? Because this is bad debt, right? We have given advances, bank has given advances to the public. And this much amount, we are sure we are not going to get. So from total advance, we have to deduct this. Clear? And provision, we have to write in a provision. Second one, interest accrued on investment. So interest accrued on investment, that means what? Interest due but not received. Then I said, right? Interest, outstanding interest. Interest to be receivable, like that it is. Now see, investment, we have invested and we got, we are able to, in a sense, we are supposed to receive the interest, not yet received. So in the interest, schedule number 13, we have to write this, and in the balance sheet, schedule number 11, other assets, because usually current assets, everything we are writing under schedule 11. Assets, only fixed assets and other assets, 10 and 11. Schedule is there. So under fixed asset we can't write. So we are writing under other assets. Schedule 11. Clear? Because it is asset, no? So we have to write. Then rebate on bills discounted. So rebate on bills discounted. Schedule number 13. Interest earned is there. So from that we have to deduct. You know this. Rebate means we are giving what is that? We are giving some kind of discount. It is not actually discount. We are paying back the customer for making the payment, little amount as encouragement. So we have to pay them back. No? So from 13, that is interest earned, we have to deduct. And schedule number 5 we have to write. Because it is liability, we have to return to the customer. So schedule number 5, other liabilities and provisions, we have to write. Clear? Then outstanding rent amounted to rupees 500. So outstanding rent, where does rent appear? Schedule 16, operating expenses. So operating expenses, there we have the rent. Rent and outstanding rent. Then another adjustment that we have to write, another schedule, is other liabilities and provisions, because outstanding rent is a liability, right? So all other liabilities we have to write under schedule 5. Clear? Outstanding rent. See, it is how you do in the horizontal balance sheet, profit and loss account, same thing. What do you do in the profit and loss account? Write in the profit and loss account, debit side, right? Rent, add outstanding. Then, where will you post the same thing? In the balance sheet, liability side. Here also same thing. Liability, schedule 5. Then, endorsement made on behalf of customers totaled the rupees 1,15,000. This we have to write under contingent liabilities, schedule number 12, because we have made the endorsement on behalf of our customers, right? Then provide statutory reserve at 25%. So it comes under appropriation. So once we got the profit, we just distribute it, right? So profit and loss account, we have to write under appropriation. And in the balance sheet, reserves, where does the reserve appear? Schedule number 2, we have to write it. Write the necessary schedules and prepare. Yeah, schedules we have to prepare, we have to show. And prepare the profit and loss account and balance sheet. So this type of problem will appear for 24 marks. Okay. So first thing, you should know the various items in the balance sheet and profit and loss account. You know, schedule 1, capital, 2, reserves, 3, deposits, 4, borrowings, 5, other liabilities and provisions, 6, cash and balances with RBI, 7, balance with bank and money and call and short notice, 8, investment, 9, advances, 10, fixed assets, 11, other assets, 12, contingent liabilities. Then we are writing this for collection. So in the profit and loss account, you know, interest earned 13, other income 14, interest expended 15, operating expenses 16, then provisions, then net profit for the year, previous year, then appropriations. Clear? So let us work out one by one. So share capital. As we identified in the first, while beginning the session, each and every item we identified, where it goes, the same thing, equity shares. So you can write neatly, 50,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each, 5 lakh, schedule 1, Schedule 2, reserves and surplus. Statutory reserve, reserve fund, it is given in the trial balance, and profit and loss account balance. So this is what profit and loss account balance. This is the profit for the current year. So profit and loss account balance you can leave blank, and after preparing profit and loss account, you can fill this, because whatever balance sheet items are there, they require the information from profit and loss account. So you can leave it blank, then later you can fill. This is the profit and loss account balance of the current year, which has appeared in the balance sheet. Then current deposits, fixed deposits, SP deposits, recurring deposits comes under deposits. Borrowings, there are no borrowings. Other liabilities and provisions, rebate, outstanding rate, I told you which are the items comes under schedule 5. So that we are writing cash and balances with RBI, money at call and short notice, balances with other banks, schedule 7. We have written schedule 8, investment, Indian government securities, this is investment, and simple another investment is given. So total investments. Then interest earned. See, what I suggest you is that if you have to prepare profit and loss account and balance sheet, it is better to prepare the profit and loss account schedules first, interest earned, all these 13, 14, 15, 16. Then you can prepare schedule 1 to 12. Okay, schedule 13, interest and discount, 1,20,000, add interest accrued. Okay, less rebate. So we got this. Other income, commission, 8,000. Interest expended not there. Operating expenses, salary, general expenses, rent, and outstanding director's fees. Right, we got this. Provisions, provision for doubtful debts, 1,500. Clear. So after finishing this, see, first thing what you do is schedule 13, 14, 15, 16, and provision, you write this. Then you can prepare profit and loss account. So schedule 13, schedule 14, interest earned and other income total, interest expended, operating expenses, provisions, so total of expenses. Profit or loss, net profit for the year, 1,32,000 minus 62,000. So you got 70,000. Clear? 70,000. Net profit or loss brought forward, this is given in the trial balance last year's, so 16,000. So total what we have is 86,000. This much profit we have in our hand. Now appropriation comes. So this side transferred to statutory reserve 25%. Be careful while transferring, you can't take 86,000. Okay, you have to take only current year's profit. So you are taking it should be 70,000. So this is, sorry, this should be 70,000. This one only, same thing you have to take. 70,000 into 25%, 17,500. Then this set transfer, in the sense interim dividend, this set. So 17,000 is here. Then from 86,000, this is the total profit, right? From that we have transferred to 17,500 to statutory reserve. This we have to write, this figure we have to write under schedule 2. So it is better to prepare a profit and loss account first, then schedule balance sheet schedules, right? So 17,500 you have to write this under schedule 2. Have you written? Yes, see here, this is transfer to statutory reserve, 17,500. Clear? Okay, then transfer to dividend. Okay, interim dividend they have given, 17,000. Balance carried forward to balance sheet. So this is the balancing figure. That means what? 86,000 minus 17,500 minus 17,000. So you got 51,500. This 51,500 should be transferred to balance sheet. Where it goes? Profit and loss account. This. this reserves and surplus, you can leave some space and continue with other things, and finally you can write. Because one is, if there is any reserve fund we have to write here, then appropriations from profit and loss account, if there is any appropriation that to transfer to the reserve, we have to write like this. And profit and loss account, how much remaining? See, do you remember while preparing the profit and loss account, we used to transfer net profit to balance sheet. Remember, in the horizontal balance sheet, net profit transfer to balance sheet. The same thing we used to take under capital, right? In the balance sheet, capital, opening capital, add net profit. Same thing here. This is the net profit. Clear? Net profit, which is remaining. So remaining net profit after transferring to all other appropriations, after making all appropriations, whatever remains, that we are writing here. Clear? See, we got this. Now finally, we can prepare the balance sheet. Capital, schedule 1, 5 lakh, reserves, then deposits, borrowings are not there, other liabilities and provisions we are writing, cash and balance with RBI, balance with bank and money at call and short notice, investments, advances, fixed assets, other assets. Then here, contingent liabilities we have written. Schedule 12. Principal collection, we have to keep it like that. I hope you understood this problem. Work out thoroughly. Study all the schedules thoroughly. Then you'll understand. Thank you.